Have you ever thought that the smartphone in your hand, the sunscreen you use at the beach, or even the sports jersey you're wearing might be hiding an invisible revolution? We're not talking about magic, but about nanotechnology. What lies behind this technology that's everywhere, yet we can't see it? The answer is in a science that's already rewriting the rules of our world, one atom at a time. If you want to discover what's behind the technology you use every day, stick with me until the end. And while you're at it, hit that like button to support science communication. To understand nanotechnology, we have to shrink down, way down. A nanometer is a billionth of a meter. To give you an idea, a human hair is about 75,000 to 100,000 nanometers wide. A DNA molecule is about 2 nanometers in diameter, and a single hydrogen atom is about a quarter of a nanometer. Nanotechnology is the science and engineering that deals with manipulating matter on this incredibly small scale, typically between 1 and 100 nanometers. At this size, materials can exhibit drastically different physical and chemical properties compared to their larger counterparts. This phenomenon is known as quantum effects. This difference in behavior allows scientists to manipulate matter in unprecedented ways, creating innovative solutions and products. The journey into this invisible world began in 1959. Physicist Richard Feynman, in a famous lecture, introduced a revolutionary idea: the possibility of manipulating individual atoms and molecules to build machines on a molecular scale. The term nanotechnology itself was coined in 1974 by Japanese professor Norio Taniguchi. But the real turning point came in 1981 with the development of the scanning tunneling microscope, or STM. Its inventors, Gerd Binnig and Heinrich Rohrer, won the Nobel Prize for it. This instrument, which works by exploiting the tunnel effect, is our eye on the atomic world. Instead of using lenses, it uses an electric current to visualize and even move individual atoms. In 1985, another fundamental discovery was made: fullerene carbon molecules. This discovery was followed by the development of carbon nanotubes in the early 90s, cylinders of carbon atoms with extraordinary strength and conductivity properties. So, how do we build with this invisible science? There are two main approaches. The first is top-down, or from the top down. Imagine taking a block of marble and sculpting it into a tiny statue. This is the method used to fabricate integrated circuits for our computers. The opposite approach is bottom-up. This is like building with Lego bricks, starting from individual atoms and molecules that self-assemble through chemical bonds. Both are crucial and are often used in combination. Amazing, right? If you're finding this journey fascinating, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon so you don't miss our next discoveries. Let me know in the comments which of these applications surprised you the most. Nanotechnology isn't science fiction. It's already a part of our daily lives. Let's look at some examples. In electronics, it has enabled the miniaturization of transistors, making our computers and smartphones faster and more powerful. It also makes OLED displays for TVs and smartphones possible, with more vivid colors and lower power consumption, and has even made flexible devices a reality. In the medical field, the applications are revolutionary. Nanobots can encapsulate drugs and deliver them directly to diseased cells, minimizing damage to healthy tissues. mRNA vaccines for COVID-19, for example, use lipid nanoparticles to encapsulate and protect the fragile mRNA. And in the future, scientists are working on surgical nanobots that can repair damaged cells, or on respirocytes, artificial red blood cells capable of carrying 236 times more oxygen. In the field of energy, nanomaterials like nanocrystals are making solar panels more efficient and enabling the development of solar paints that turn entire walls into power generators. Silicon nanowires and carbon nanotubes increase the capacity and durability of lithium batteries. And in materials? Silicon nanoparticles can make fabrics water-repellent and stain-resistant, while silver nanoparticles make them antibacterial. And did you know that graphene is the thinnest material in the world, but is 200 times stronger than steel? But with such great power comes great responsibility and significant concerns. Due to their tiny size, nanoparticles can easily penetrate our bodies through inhalation, skin, or ingestion. Materials considered harmless at larger scales can become harmful at the nanoscale, like certain forms of carbon nanotubes that are considered as dangerous as asbestos. Then there are environmental risks, like the contamination of water and soil from products like socks with silver nanoparticles. Then there are ethical risks, like human enhancement, which raises questions about fairness and identity. And then there's the famous gray goo scenario described in 1986 by K.E. Eric Drexler, the idea of out-of-control, self-replicating nanobots that could consume all organic matter on Earth. It's a fascinating and terrifying idea, though for now, it remains pure science fiction. Share this video with a friend to show them how science fiction has already become a reality. Nanotechnology is a rapidly evolving scientific frontier that is already reshaping what's possible. We are just beginning to scratch the surface of this invisible world, but its impact is set to redefine every aspect of our lives. But one question remains: are we ready to handle such great power? And which future application fascinates or worries you the most? Thanks for watching. Don't forget to leave your thoughts in the comments below. See you in the next video.